Hello, good evening. Welcome to the Parish Art Museum. My name is Corinne Ernie. I am the Deputy Director of Curatorial Affairs here at the Parish. And it's a wonderful night. We have been providing this every Friday night for you. Beautiful space, beautiful weather. And the music tonight is a special treat. It's the Lighthouse Project in tribute to Elvin Jones. And our dear partner, Klaus Brondahl from the Hamptons Jazz Fest will tell you more about the band. And meanwhile, I would like to thank our Friday night sponsors, our presenting sponsor, Bank of America, Weill Cornell Medicine in Southampton, and the Corcoran Group. And now I would like to turn the word to Klaus Brondahl, who has been bringing incredible music to us all summer, and this actually concludes our summer music series. Klaus. Yes.
Well, look, and this is a news flash to me. So this is the last one? Oh, well, we're just getting started. Well, anyway, thank you for coming. And again, we are humbled and we are amazed that you folks keep showing up for our events. It's greatly appreciated, and we don't take it for granted anymore. We'll always enjoy a live audience from this day forward. But thank you. My name is Klaus Brondahl. I'm the Executive Director of Hamptons Jazz Fest. If you want to get on our mailing list, we do have a young lady walking around with a little book. We'll take your email, and you'll be up to date with all the events we do year-round, whether it's the jam session, jazz night, Hamptons Jazz Fest, winter jazz series, or our weekly radio shows. We do a lot of things as a nonprofit organization. Anyway, without much further ado, we are here with a wonderful project, with the Lighthouse Project, with some of my favorite musicians since I was a very young person. We'll do a little interview here. We are here with Sun TV, and my partner in crime, Peter Walsh, will actually give you a little bit of insight as part of the backstage program on this TV station here. So he will do a little 5-minute interview and give you some information about who these musicians are and why they do what they do. So give it up for Mr. Peter Walsh.
Thank you, Klaus. Thank you, Joel. This is amazing. The Hamptons Jazz Festival is one of the greatest secrets going on in the jazz world. And every time someone comes to one of the shows, the first thing they say is, we don't believe the world-class quality. And that's what it is. It's world-class quality, just like this wonderful museum, the Parish. It's so good to join with the Parish and jazz together, art and jazz. Listen, America gave the world democracy. And then we gave it jazz. These are the two gifts we gave the world. So I'd like to thank all. Very good. And let's keep both, she said. Isn't that the truth? But let's get out and meet some of these great artists who are playing tonight. And I have to say, I want to begin with, you know, Gene Perla on bass. You're going to hear, again, one of the great bassists. People come just to watch him, his fingers fly. But he played. He played with Elvin Jones. And the Elvin Jones family, maybe you know Hank Jones on piano. Maybe you knew his brother who played bass. I mean, these guys were unbelievable. The Jones family, they came from Detroit. Thank you very much. There he goes. And here we go. And I'm going to come right back here to our bass man tonight. Gene, you played with the great Elvin. What was it like?
Was it like when I was a student at Berklee School in Boston, I was listening to records and learning about jazz, and I heard this one particular record. It was a Wayne Shorter record, and Elvin was playing drums on it, and at the end of one of the melodies of one of the songs they played, he played a drum fill, and the way he played the bass drum on that fill before the first solo started impressed me so much that I decided that I wanted to go to New York, and I knew I had to go to New York if I wanted to get up into the musical world, and I wanted to play with him.
Now, you did 455 gigs.
How many is that? Am I right?
455, yeah.
So 450 gigs with the master. Now, I have to say, I'm looking at Adam Nussbaum here, and he's wearing that beautiful jacket he has on. There's a lot of pressure on him. when you're in a band and you're taking over Elvin's position.
Right.
And that's where I have it. How about you introduce the rest of our band tonight?
Okay, thank you. Well, let's start with Mr. Nussbaum. Come on, tell us something about yourself.
Hi, my name's Adam, and it's nice to be here, and I'm grateful to be able to play this music. I was very fortunate to hear many of my heroes live. Elvin was one of my mentors. He was a very encouraging gentleman and gave me a lot of support. And that's something that's very nice when you meet your heroes and you see that they're just beautiful people. So the first time I heard Gene was about 50 years ago playing with Elvin. And I pretty much learned how to play drums by hearing him as well as hearing Mr. Jones and hearing all the good music. So I'm kind of sitting in one of my father's chairs and I'm just doing my best to put the groovelation in formation and try to keep everybody with some elation.
You're gonna meet the rest of the band as the night goes on. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for the Lighthouse Project.
So that was a song by Frank Foster called Simone. Now we're going to play one of my original compositions. It's called Sambra, recorded in Brazil.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Mr. Liebman, David Liebman, couldn't be with us tonight, and very happy. I'm very pleased to have Nicole Glover join us. The first time I heard this girl play, I said, uh-oh. I got to get next to her. But in the spirit of David Liebman, we're going to play one of his songs now. It's called Bright Peace. Thank you. A wonderful surprise for me and for us and for you, because he happens to be your neighbor. He's here. He's here tonight, and he's agreed to come and play a song with us. And maybe two. Mr. Randy Brecker is getting his trumpet. Here he comes. All the other times. And before we go any further, I've mentioned everyone in the band except a wonderful man that I've known now for many decades and had the wonderful pleasure of playing with him, and I'm so happy to be able to do it again, Mr. Jerry Berganzi. Thank you. Jones song. It comes from that, I guess you'd call it kind of a game, a shyster game that they used to play on the street.
He learned it on a cruise ship.
Right? Yeah, it's called Three Card Molly. That's the name of the song.
Thank you.
Miss Nicole Glover on the saxophone. Mr. Jerry Baganzi on the saxophone. Mr. Adam Nussbaum on the drums. I want to thank everyone for coming tonight and this afternoon and tonight, and thank you for the management to have us here. It's been a wonderful experience, even though the Long Island Expressway is not my favorite road. Anyway, my name is Gene Perla, and we're the Lighthouse Project. Thank you.